September 1st, 1989, opening game of the year. Good kickoff coverage against Chartiers Valley, no run back. This was a tough game, but not very good pass coverage here. But in the end zone, the Panther D got tough. Bat it down. Yards were tough to come by. There was good punt coverage too. And good defense. Plug that hole. Oh yeah. Little deflection and interception here. He'll take it. And at the end of the first quarter, no score. Tough defense against the run in the second quarter. The running game started to get in gear. Great fake there. And then the first touchdown, right up the gut. Thank you. Once again, good kickoff coverage. And on defense, great hit after the reception. Rip up the playbook, Charval. Good D, breaking this one up. And a good pitch on the option. And on this play, everybody's wondering where the ball is, including the cameraman. Followed up pretty good. It's in the end zone for a touchdown. 14-0. And the kickoff. Got a few yards here, but not enough. Panthers back on O then. Nice run, good for about 20. And then the trap play to perfection inside the 15-yard line. You gotta work for the touchdown. Come on in, Junko. Time for the point after. It's 21-0 USC with 10:32 remaining. Some nice D. Causes the fumble for a safety or a touchdown or a safety or a touchdown or a safety. A touchdown. Come on, Junk, get that extra point. 28-0. Go back to that famous kickoff coverage of the Panthers. And the way they tell you to do it, or at least it helps, deflection, interception. It's now 34-0. More good kick coverage. And more good D. Everybody helps. Back, 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 back. Quick pass, quick interception, and a quick run back. All the way inside the five. And on offense, a nice run. Everybody jump on board. 34-0 USC over Charvalley. The Panthers were 1-0. They won their second game of the year by beating Trinity 55-0. Another shutout. Let's start with Upper St. Clair at Mount Lebanon. The opening kickoff set the tone for this game. And on the opening series, the Panther D goes to work. They pull the Blue Devils down for a loss. The first punt set up the first score in the game. Fumbled snap for Mount Lebanon. Upper St. Clair gets it deep inside Blue Devil territory. The running game set up the first touchdown. Nice move. And there is the touchdown. The Panthers on the board first. The second kickoff leads to bad field position again. Blue Devils having problem trying to catch the kickoff. Back on offense, Phil Dunn, a big catch, 27 yards. And when in doubt, how about some defense? On either end of the field, Wetzel with the big sack right here. Mount Lebanon forced the punt, but guess what? Trouble again. They get it off, but nothing to brag about. Mike Quealy, the touchdown from Gentile, 22 yards. Panthers in business again. Mount Lebanon was driving, but Kevin Ory, the big fumble recovery. Suddenly, the Panthers out of another jam. On the ground, no problem. Doug Whaley right up the middle. And watch this pitch by Mark. Great effort by Gentile. Knows when to pitch it off, and there's some more yardage. Pete Habib breaks the Mount Lebanon defense. On this play, Habib goes 69 yards every which way. But what counts is it's an Upper St. Clair touchdown. Another Upper St. Clair touchdown. Panthers in total control of this one. Back to the air. Gentile to Dunn. Nice grab. Then Whaley sneaks up the middle for another touchdown. On this kickoff, Mount Lebanon finally got it going. The Blue Devils make some hay. They find an opening, and it's into Upper St. Clair territory. But back on defense, Mount Lebanon couldn't do much. The running game is in gear for the Panthers. That sets up this. Whaley, nice blocking on the line, a touchdown for the Panthers. And on defense, Whaley does it the other way. Give him a sack. And on offense, pitch it out and try to get something out of that one. This one was a little bit better. Paul Bellis breaks through the line. Another Panther touchdown. This is just turning into a real runaway. Blue Devils say, oh no, we're back on the kickoff return. You know what that means? They saw this all night. Another fumble, another recovery. Just that kind of night for the Blue Devils. Same story when the Panthers were in the dark jerseys. This is the game against Baldwin. Dunn, Wetzel, and the gang cashing in. On offense, Habib around end. And on offense, the offensive line drives Baldwin back for Doug, and he does the rest. And then a great fake on this touchdown pass. It's Gentile to Quealy. Touchdown for Upper St. Clair. Good night, Mona. He's long gone. Upper St. Clair starts off early. The defense holds. thanks to plays like this. And Dunn comes up with the big hit. Ooh, everybody could feel that one. And how about a blitz? Dunn says, yes, thank you. Special teams were also key. Punt coverage. Not bad at all. In fact, make it super. Great coverage. That Panther wall. And then Terry Hammonds makes the big interception. Panther defense means business on this night. How about some more D? A guy named Whaley. He's not faked out on this play. INT! And even when Baldwin connected, there were big hits and trick plays. Where's the ball on this one? Pat Conley to Mike Quealy for the big touchdown. And a nice hit by Paul Bellis, 14-0. Upper St. Clair wins. And another shutout for the Panther defense. St. Clair, North Hills, big run by Whaley right after North Hills had scored, so USC is right back at him. That set up a touchdown, and guess who's on the receiving end? Whaley. Then there was a very important extra point, but it was nailed. We've got a tie game. Kickoff coverage was excellent in this game at the beginning. You can see why on this play. After a fumble, North Hills scores again to make it 20-7. They missed the big extra point, but they were still ahead in the game. It was definitely going the Indians' way. Here's another touchdown. This was a good night to root for the team in red, or at least they thought. Extra point is good. But here come the Panthers. Back in the game, nice pass right there on a basically run drive. Then Habib goes right up the middle. And that sets up this run by Whaley. Right up the gut, good night Mona. And guess who's back in the game? Another big extra point. It's now 26-14. Halftime score was 27-14, North Hills. Third quarter, Habib around the end. That starts a third quarter drive, and suddenly North Hills is a little concerned. Penalties helped. Interference call to keep the drive alive. Then Habib spins through the middle. Nice gain. And a little trickery, Gentile. Who's got the ball? And when in doubt, improvise. Try to get that yardage any way you can. Inside the 10. Back to Habib. Breaks through two tacklers here. Upper St. Clair touchdown. Panthers are back in it. Another very important extra point. 27-21, it's a still only third quarter. Defense gets into the act. Pressure on Bender. Changed the whole complexion of the ball game. And the defense made the big plays like this play. Quealy comes up with it. Nice hit. but it was not called a lateral. Colonna in the backfield, McKeever coming up. Forget it. Nobody was fooled on that play. Colonna and Dunn then make the big play. Some pressure. Incomplete. And another big hit in the backfield. Hammond deflects the pass here. That saves a big gain. Then they seal the corner here. Nice game for the Panthers on offense. And who could forget this one? Oh yeah, what an effort. The try for two failed. 8 minutes left in the game. 27-26 USC. More offense when it counted. Habib spins out. Big gain. But North Hills gets the ball back at a fumble. Defense again. Kevin Ory picks off a big one. Five runs into the line, did very little. Queely comes in to punt. Excellent coverage by the punt team, and a big tackle by Bellis. It causes a fumble. USC wins it 27-26 over North Hills in a nationally televised cable game. The defense was the key against Shaler. Whaley converts a fumble into the first touchdown. On defense, Bryson and Dunn put pressure on the quarterback to force the incomplete pass. Not even close. Martin then applies the pressure. Ory just misses the big interception. But it's still a big incomplete pass. Pressure again. Terry Hammond breaks up the pass. Nothing's working for Shaler. And defense comes up with a big play on the punt. Puts the offense in excellent field position. Junko boots it through for a big three. Take the points. And on defense, Dunn with the big hit. Too bad there was no slow-mo. Queely does it on both ends. Interception here for Queely. And not a bad run back. Couple plays later, back on offense. Queely with the big, big touchdown pass from Gentile. On defense, Terry and Phil combined for another loss. Then pressure and a great read by Terry Hammonds. Panthers making it look easy. This results in an Upper St. Clair score. Keith Martin finds the ball and runs for the touchdown. And the good plays just kept on coming. Gentile, nice pass. And a super catch by Eric. Back to the air again. Play action. Pass to Kevin Ory. What a catch there. That set up the touchdown run by Habib. And with 3:36 left in the second quarter, 37-0, Upper St. Clair in the lead. Keith saves a big run by showing some real hustle on this play. Another one gone, another one gone, another one bites the dust. offense, Don Lauer shows some real nice footwork and scores another Upper St. Clair touchdown. Keith Martin makes the hit and J.B. Kress recovers. Another big play on special teams. The rain falling hard. Lou Wetzel reads the screen and takes a beating, but puts on the finishing touch. Jeff Wilson breaks two tackles on this nice sweep. Keep going, Jeff. And Pat Conley with a nice interception on defense. Nice blocking by the line and a nice run by McLaughlin. Final score, 47-7 USC over Shaler. After a short run and an incomplete pass, Mark connects with Doug for the touchdown. 16-0 lead for Upper St. Clair as the two teams head to the locker room. After a slow start in the second half, Jim Colonna makes a big hit. Sean Bryson recovers the fumble. Another big play for the Panther defense. And in the mud, it doesn't matter. Pete makes some moves and gets some blocking. How did he do that? Kevin Ory breaks up a third down pass on defense. Upper St. Clair doing it on both ends of the ball. And you want big plays? How about this? Kevin McKeever. Fourth down attempt. Stopped by USC. Any chance Ringgold had of getting back in the game is dropped. Mike Quealy gets off a critical punt. And again, he draws the roughing call. That's it for Ringgold. 16-0. USC wins it. Against North Allegheny, you want anticipation? Phil Dunn reads this one perfectly. NA does get on the board, though, with a long run. But it's a long game. And here come the Panthers. They're led back by Mark Gentile. Nice pass to Quealy, all the way down to the 44-yard line. Then Doug finds another seam. Nice gain with some great downfield blocking. And for the final 15 yards, it looks pretty awesome. The game-tying TD. Take just about everybody out. And the very important point after somehow made it go. Kickoff coverage is excellent. And back on offense, big third down run by Pete for an important first down. And he did hold, though, and got the ball back. But they couldn't do much. Look at the coverage on the option. Executed well by everyone, Doug makes the stop. After a couple short runs, Mark opens up with the pass. Quealy with the circus catch. Oh, yeah. The line provides excellent blocking. Pete slips around left. Nice gain to end the half. It's a 7-7 tie. Second half, nice start. Pete grabs the kickoff and takes it for a big gain, letting NA know who's king. Then Mike Quealy almost breaks free for a nice pass from Gentile. Mark finds Mike at the goal line for a first down. And then Doug finds the goal line behind some great blocking. USC is up 14-7 as the man known as Junko adds the extra point. Pete makes a big interception on third down, but turns it over. The mud starting to take its toll. After another near interception on the play, NA finds a hole up the middle for a big gain. And a saving tackle by Ory. And it ties the score in the next play. It's 14-14 with 3:35 left in the third. USC ends up punting and gets a great kickoff by Quealy. Super coverage, too, by Whaley. And the pressure from the D-line almost causes another interception. Upper St. Clair's aggressive defense forces NA to punt. USC has the ball at the start of the fourth quarter, but turns it over. After two short runs by Pete, Doug picks up a big first down And then Gentile finds Dunn, and Phil shows some great speed. Who's running that camera? Jutko adds the important extra point, and with 2:17 left in the game, Panthers are in control. And he tries to fool the defense, but Kevin comes up with the interception to stop any chance of an NA score. USC wins it. The final is 21-14. Against Butler, the opening drive on offense for Upper St. Clair results in a touchdown. But guess what? It's called back. The first break of the game for the Panthers. Then it took some good D. Mike Queely breaks up the long pass attempt. Panther defense contributing to the cause. And there's some more D. Interception here by Keith Martin off the deflected pass. Panthers have the ball. Then it's Doug Whaley's turn. Third and 10, takes the handoff, and he goes 65 yards for the touchdown. No penalty flags on this play. Touchdown for Whaley and Upper St. Clair. Kickoff coverage almost results in a turnover. Lou Wetzel with the awesome hit almost forces the fumble. Then on defense, Keith Martin, Andy Weldy, and Lou Wetzel stop the screen. And the defensive line got into the act. The D-line puts a little pressure on the Butler QB, forces them to throw this one out of bounds. Try next time. Butler did score on a pass play, but they missed the extra point, so it was 7-6 with 6:40 to play. Back on offense, Doug Whaley makes a nice gain on a short pass. Lou Wetzel lets him know he's there. And Mike Queely makes a diving save. Some nice D for the Panthers. McKeever follows with some good pass defense on a fourth down pass attempt. This is when it counts. So it's 7-6 at halftime. Second half, Upper St. Clair takes the kickoff. Whaley takes it all the way for a touchdown. Jutko's extra point makes it 14-6 Panthers. On the kickoff team, Jim Kalana puts a big hit on Butler. Not much of a return on that play. USC has the ball. John Thomas almost breaks one back on offense. But Butler holds and gets the ball back. Wetzel, though, greets the Butler back again. And some more good defense. Kevin Ory makes a saving tackle. And that would be a big one. Wetzel and company again greet the Butler backfield. And that good old-fashioned pass defense tightened up again. And again. Butler scores on a great play and they go for two. There's the touchdown. And the two-point conversion tied it at 14. Butler holds and Queely punts again. But excellent coverage. On defense, the D-line pressure causes an incompletion. USC takes over. John Thomas, nice hole, and he drags tacklers for a couple extra yards. Another hole by the line, and the downfield escort by Mowersberg allows Doug to spin to the 2-yard line. Then that offensive line gets tough inside. They seal the right side, Doug scores, and Junko adds a point after. USC leads 21-14. Butler almost breaks a big one, but Queely makes the saving tackle on this play. These are the kind that win ball games. Then another big stop by the defense. The drive is stopped with some very big plays. Interception by McKeever stops the Butler drive. And Whaley spins free and breaks a big run to give Upper St. Clair a 2-touchdown lead. No way you're going to catch him, and it's 28-14 after the point after. After Butler got the ball, USC holds. On the first play after the punt, Doug goes right back to work. He breaks a tackle and goes in for the score. The point after is blocked, but it's still 34-14, Panthers in the lead. Butler starts to mount another drive, but McKeever shuts them down big. John Thomas provides some tough running. He gains 13 on this play. And some nice running around the right side seals the win. Upper St. Clair wins it 34-14 over Butler. Against Hempfield, USC defense on the opening play tells Hempfield it was going to be a long day. Defensive line pressure and tight coverage puts the ball in Render's hands. On USC's opening offensive drive, Mike Queely takes an end around down to the Hempfield 30-yard line. Then Doug gets a nice hole and breaks an arm tackle and another tackle and gets the first down at the 15. But Hempfield holds on fourth at the 10. Nice throw by Gentile and a catch by Queely for another first down. Then pressure on the quarterback forces the incompletion and a fourth down. USC fumbles the punt. Hempfield has the ball and starts a drive. But Phil Dunn comes up with the fumbled handoff. USC gives the ball right back and the USC defense toughens. Big hole and Doug chews up some yardage. Then Gentile to Eric Lund for a nice gain. And some great offensive line blocking puts the ball on the goal line. Easy pickings for Doug. He takes it in for the touchdown. Hempfield tries a reverse, but Terry and Doug are right there to stop it. Nobody's fooled on this play. Then pressure and a sack by Weldy causes the fumble. It's recovered by Kalana and end the half. That also stops the Hempfield drive. After the opening kickoff, Doug takes the first handoff and races for a 55-yard touchdown. Junko adds the extra point to make it 14-0 up for St. Clair. A mishandled kickoff and a hit by Kalana put Hempfield deep in their own territory. Once again, the kickoff team contributing. Another bad punt and a USC bounce gives the Panthers excellent field position. Then Queely on the end around works again for a big gain. And Doug Whaley races around end for the score. The point after fails by Junko, but it was still 20-0, Upper St. Clair in the lead. Partially blocked punt here. USC is in great field position once again. A big completion puts the ball on the Panther 2-yard line, and Hempfield scores. The extra point is good, and the lead is down to 20-7. But the Panthers get tough on offense. Doug Whaley breaks a number of tackles, gets some tremendous blocking, 75-yard run. Junko adds the point after, and the Panthers in control by 20. It was a 27-7 lead. The ensuing kickoff almost ends up a touchdown, but McKeever makes the saving tackle. Another big play that contributes to a win. Hempfield's on offense, deep inside Upper St. Clair territory, but Weldy reads the play, throws him for a big loss. And finally, fourth down. They're going for the money, but it's incomplete. Wilson takes his man into the stands. And then Doug squirts through the hole for a big gain, eating up the clock, and that's what counts. Then Gentile sets up and throws a strike to Conley.
That's it.
Hempfield stiffens and Junko adds three. The consistent foot of Junko makes it 30-7. And the defense got into the act again. Pressure and good secondary coverage and a nice hit by Queely to end it. The bootleg fools nobody on this play, forces the quarterback out of bounds instead. Hempfield finally puts another on the board. They add the point after, but it's still 30-14. Onside kick fails. Upper St. Clair has the ball on the 50 with 3:42 left in the game. And when Hempfield has the ball, the defense comes up with the big play. That's a safety. Upper St. Clair beats Hempfield 32-14. Against Woodland Hills, the opening series for Woodland Hills ends with a fumble recovery by Doug Whaley. Right away, the defense getting into this one. Some nice ball handling freezes the Woodland Hills defense. Mike Queely throws a strike to Pat Conley. Point after is missed, but it's still 6-0 Panthers. Weldy and Habib combine to stop the option on defense. And the defense tightens up to stop Woodland Hills on a fourth and short. No way, Jose. Upper St. Clair stopped and punts. And the gang tackling gets into the game here. Woodland Hills fullback is stopped there by a bunch. And Weldy almost creates a turnover with a nice hit. And then Dunn, as in Phil, comes up with the big interception. He does more than that. He takes it back for a touchdown after the pressure from the defensive line. The point after is good, and Upper St. Clair leads this game 13-0. Then Phil on defense reads the screen and shuts down the big play. Woodland Hills goes for fourth and short with the trick play, but nobody's fooled, including Phil Dunn. But it's been no better roses. Upper St. Clair back to punt. Watch the effort by Quayle. Bad snap, gets it off, draws the roughing the kicker call, and look at the kick inside the five. Some nice coverage by Whaley, stops him at the two. But Upper St. Clair has the ball on the roughing call. Gentile drops back in the next play and hits Dunn with a strike. It's a touchdown for Upper St. Clair. And the Panthers are in business. It was 20-0 with the point after. And there was more defense. Option stopped again. And the first half ends with USC in total control, 20-0. Second half, defense gets a piece of the punt. And the offense has some phenomenal field position. What do you get when you give Doug Whaley some good blocking? Well, this is what you get. Picks up 12 big yards, and then 10 more to the left. Mike Wheely then starts left on the end around and ends up picking up yardage to the right. Then Pete picks up a big first down. Gentile throws a nice pass to Quealy, and Woodland Hills gets called for interference. Otherwise, it would have been six. But it didn't matter. Whaley scores, making things even. And the Panthers decide to go for two. Peak takes the pitch and converts it. And the score is 27-0. Upper St. Clair in control in the third quarter. Minnick holds off a blocker and stops a potential big gain. Almost recovers the fumble, too. The drive is finally stopped when T steps in front and picks off that pass. Not a bad run back either for T. Then on offense, Whaley gets the first down behind some good blocking. And the defense continued to shut down Woodland Hills. The final was 27-0. Upper St. Clair wins it over Woodland Hills. And then it was time for the big game. Kickoff at Three River Stadium, Whipple Quad A Championship, another game with North Hills. Not a bad start for the Indians, but it got much worse in this game. Terry Hammond starts it off, knocks down the pass of Jeff Bender. Terry liked it so much that he went after it and got the next one. Hammond's with the interception of Bender.
Bender firing deep, got a man open on the sideline.
Nice effort. But North Hills held and they got the ball back. But once again, it's the Upper St. Clair defense. Joel Minnick with the sack, no gain.
Scrambles again and gets back to the line of scrimmage. Joel Minnick, number 57.
And then Dunn and Whaley with the big hits on Bender.
The keeper
almost fumbled the ball. Take a look at it in slow-mo.
We've got a decision to make for Jack McCurry.
Well, this was a designed run all the way, a quarterback sweep with Jeff Bender carrying a football. But Phil Dunn comes from the inside linebacking position. Nice through fine. But
the bad news is two-way starter Lou Wetzel out with a sprained right knee. But the crowd was still excited as the Panthers started to prowl. Phil Dunn here on the blitz. Nice play on defense. And then Minnick, a big hit pursuing Chris Helen, the ball carrier, end of the first quarter. This time how about a slow-mo of that?
Defensive end who comes in to make the stop for North Hills.
You can see the whole Upper St. Clair defense is flowing down the line of scrimmage. There's no place for Chris Helen to turn upfield. When he turns up, he gets gang tackled by the Upper St. Clair defense. We talked about the running backs for Upper St. Clair, but our defense is
third down.
And then Kevin Ory makes the play of the game. The Panthers are up 7-0.
Jeff Bender
forces the throw, interception. And it's good night, Mona. Touchdown for the Panthers. With the point after, it was 7-0 Upper St. Clair.
Kevin Ory, the senior. Six from the 30.
And the defense tighten again. Ory with another interception.
Bender throws and it is intercepted.
He picks off another pass.
First and 10.
Then on a first and 10 from the 46, Phil Dunn on an end around. Some nice running here. Faked even the cameraman. All the way down to the 10-yard line before he's pushed out of bounds. Then they go to the air. Gentile with the fake. Everybody's buying it. And he goes to the air for the touchdown. The point after makes it 14-0 Panthers. Nice slow-mo view of their second touchdown of the night. Phil's not fooled on this play. Quarterback draw, but Bender is nailed.
Third down and 28.
And when he does get the ball off, another pickoff. Mike Quealy, interception to stop another drive. Take a look at a slow-mo version of one of the nicest interceptions you'll see.
Two deep safeties back here. All of a sudden, here comes Mike Quealy in the open. You think Chris Helen is open downfield? That's not the case. Mike Quealy.
On offense, Doug Whaley gets a hole, and you know what happens then. He breaks some tackles all the way down to the 13-yard line.
25, 20. He's still on his feet.
Good effort. And Junko did the rest, a 36-yarder, added three more. The Panthers in control. Just a lot of room to spare, too, on the crossbar, Junko. And then the defense to work again. Quealy pulls it in.
Fires on the run and the pass.
Yes, sirree, it's an interception to shut down the North Hills offense. Slow-mo, the pressure on Bender.
Running for his life, getting all kind of pressure.
The throw.
The football up for grab,
and another interception.
Mike Quealy comes out of nowhere, gets it at its high point.
Almost looked like Quealy's interception earlier in the game.
Again, he was looking for his...
Habib then goes to the blitz. This one forces another incompletion.
It'll be an incompletion. Pete Habib, number 35 and a corner blitz.
And then Phil makes a big tackle on a fourth down play to end the half. It was 17-0 at halftime. Upper St. Clair in total control of the ball game. Second half, Upper St. Clair, second down and 8. Gentile to Quealy. Spectacular catch at the 37-yard line. Back to the running game then. Pete Habib dances his way for a nice gain.
Habib breaking tackles and a terrific.
All the way down to the 45. Just keeps his legs pumping for a nice gain.
Just keep those legs going and get his shoulder pads down.
In the air, Gentile throws a strike to Dunn and breaks the Indians back. The point after is good. It's 24-0 Upper St. Clair. Quealy then picks up where he left off. Again on defense, his third interception of the night, thanks to a deflection. Out of bounds at the 21-yard line. Habib gets the hole and takes the next one in, leading everybody. Point after is good, and it's 31-0 Panthers. There's a slow-mo of the touchdown.
He just breaks a tackle, not very many moves, right up the middle. Good blocking by the offense.
Upper St. Clair helmet, a good helmet to wear on this night on the AstroTurf. North Hills forced the punt. Panthers get the ball again, and they make it count. Gentile to Dunn for a big gain. It's 31-0 in the fourth quarter. Upper St. Clair over North Hills on their way to a win. Quealy then scores on the option. He converts the first and 10. It's a touchdown. Add six more. Back to defense. Joel Minnick with the big stop.
Jeff Bender hands off to Kevin Golis. Tough hit in there by Joel. Six quad A championship games.
The crowd's excited, and these are the faces of champions.
Four games total. First and 10, Upper St. Clair.
Complete pass for North Hills here.
Bender back to throw, fires.
But Kevin McKeever with a great tackle. And then North Hills finally scores. They missed the two-point conversion. It didn't matter much anyway.
Near the goal line, and he's in. The 8-yard line.
Just about everything was working. How about a pitch left?
Pitching wide.
Got by the tackler there and at least got a couple out of it.
Dave interception.
And then how about this one? Bad snap. Quealy throws to Kalana.
It's a fake. And the pass.
Not a bad run, Jim. What speed? Only no deal. The flags are down.
There are flags all over the field, though. Jim Kalona, the nose guard.
Well, they can't do anything wrong.
I hope his parents' VCR's running.
Two more of the heroes, Ori and Habib, having some fun.
Start out now from their 30.
With the score 38-6, North Hills goes to the reverse. They get 8 out of it, but again, not mattering much. They got some more on a lucky tip. Turns into a completion. It is complete. And inside the 40-yard line of Upper St. Clair. Quealy, a big night with 3 interceptions.
Touchdown pass, touchdown run on an option. What a night he's had. Being taken out one by one, Phil Dunn.
And just for good measure with the credits running, the defense comes up with the big stop. Coaching guru Jim Render smells another championship. And the crowd says, how about a Gatorade shower?
Down 38-6, trying to punch in another
play, nor will they.
The team says, fine. Jim doesn't mind getting wet this night. Upper St. Clair, Whitfield champions again. Against Hollidaysburg, the opening kickoff on the artificial turf. And on offense for the Panthers, open up that big hole. Whaley finds daylight all the way down to the Hollidaysburg 7-yard line. And at the end of the first possession, Habib scores. Point after is good. 7-0. On D, a brick wall and a fumble recovery by Kalana. They made it count. Gentile to Ori on the bootleg. Point after is good. It's 14-0 Panthers. On the kickoff, Junko shows why he does more than kick. There's the kick, and you watch the rest. A saving tackle courtesy of Junko. Whaley finds daylight to the Hollidaysburg 33-yard line. After several runs and an interference call, touchdown by Habib through a big hole. Point after is good, and the first quarter ends at 21-0 Panthers. Fake punt is converted to give Hollidaysburg the ball on the Panther 40. And they score on the long pass. They added the point after, and the lead was down to 21-7. Back within a couple touchdowns. On the kickoff, a little bit of trickery, but it doesn't work. Onside kick fails, Upper St. Clair's ball. Whaley scores on a 3rd and 15. With the PAT, it's 28-0. Don't try to catch him because you won't. And on defense, the screen is red and almost results in an interception for Joel. John Thomas breaks for a 60-yard run and the celebration that follows. And if you can't score the touchdown, how about three by Junko? 31-7. And on the kickoff, another saving tackle is needed. And another sack by the defense. Hollidaysburg picks up a couple first downs and they get a break. Deflection, completion, touchdown, 31-14. Hollidaysburg recovers a fumble at the USC 18. Batee comes up with the interception, but he's rolled out of bounds. Ori comes up with the big interception, and that is inbounds. That stops the drive, and the half ends. USC gets the ball and grinds it out 25 yards in the second half. Gentile to Dunn. Point after is good, 28-14. Gentile to Queely, nice gain. And even Ori tries running the ball. Or throwing. Or running. Then Conley around the other end. Inside the 25-yard line. Then Queely puts icing on the cake. 45-14 with the point after. Was Queely innocent on this play? You make the call. Cooler heads eventually prevail. Joel, did you leave something on the field? Somebody get him. And how about this one? The old bell play. Ding, ding. Interception for USC.
That's it. That's it.
Nice gain on that one inside the 15. That converts a fourth down. And then Bob gets his first score. And the route is on. They almost connect, but what a great defensive play. Holidaysburg almost made a count here, but Joe Ferris with the saving tackle. Somebody run him down. Joe finally does to save a touchdown. Jeff Wilson takes it around right end. And he gets nailed. Lawler almost connects with Newman on this play. Up, but no reception. And on defense, almost a sack. But the pass is broken up by a whole bunch of defenders. 51-21 was the final. And the Upper St. Clair Panthers were on to Chocolate Town for the state championship against Wilson. It was a cold night at Hershey Stadium, but Keith Martin didn't seem to mind. He plays the right side tough. Weldy, with those frozen hands, bats down a pass to stop Wilson on third down. And then Brian Wilson, no relation to the Beach Boy, pancakes the Wilson linebacker. And finally, Pete Habib finds daylight around left end and scores the Panthers' first touchdown on it, their first possession. Point after is missed. Look at New Star 4 in the background. I was in the truck keeping warm. Defense shuts down the run. And you make the call on this play. Did Kevin catch it? Questionable, but it looked pretty good to me. Of course, there's one advantage to the hard, frozen ground. Lucky bounces. There's one disadvantage to the cold, getting hit by this kind of defensive line. They also read the draw. And they force a punt. And watch what happens on the punt return. Conley almost twists free. Almost also describes this play by Pete Habib. He almost breaks another after running over the Wilson defenders. Little razzle-dazzle on a reverse pitch from Conley to Ori. Results in an interception on a big play by the Wilson defender. Nice interception. But the defense shuts down Wilson. Gain of only about one on this play. And the pass pressure hurries the throw. The coverage downfield results in an incompletion. Galano runs down the reverse. And this time, the official calls the interference. But Wilson got the ball back. Weldy with the big stick. And the draw doesn't fool anyone. It's now fourth down. Panthers come up with the big block. And on offense, Gentile completes a pass to Whaley coming out of the backfield. Whaley almost Burroughs goes for a long one. Dunn and Quealy, some great blocks leading the way. But Wilson holds and USC punts. Quealy buries Wilson at their own 8-yard line. And the defense stiffens. Kalana breaks through and breaks up the run. And you make the call. Was the ball? Quarterback deep in his own territory, but he completes a big pass for a first down at the 32-yard line. But Martin came up with one of his big sacks to push Wilson back to its own 23. But Wilson comes up with another big play. On fourth down, they keep their hopes alive. And on this play. Queely stays with the receiver and almost picks it off. Eventually, Wilson had to turn the ball over to the Panthers. And all they had to do was kill the clock. Upper St. Clair wins the state championship to go along with its Whippeal championship and let the celebration begin in Chocolate Town. Congratulations to head coach Jim Render, the champion Upper St. Clair Panthers, and their champion fans. Now watch and listen to more post-game celebration and highlights from Hershey. This is Albie Oxenrider reporting on the championship season of the Upper St. Clair Panthers.